Livestock Valuation, Assets Expenditure and Remedial Matters Bill, third reading.
Mr Speaker.
The Honourable Todd McClay.
Mr Speaker, I move that the Taxation, Livestock Valuation, Assets Expenditure and Remedial Matters Bill be now read a third time. Mr Speaker, it has been the Government's ongoing focus to steadily reduce inconsistencies and anomalies in our tax system in order to make it fairer for all taxpayers. This bill continues that focus. To remind members, I want to briefly summarise the main contents of this bill. The bill addresses the tax treatment of assets used both privately and for earning income, including holiday homes, boats and aircraft. Following on from the changes to livestock valuation rules and budget 2012 legislation, this bill contains the detailed supporting provisions, rules to general proposal of the irrevocability of the herd scheme election, a proposal to treat lease inducement payments and lease surrender payments as taxable income for the recipient and tax deductible expenditure for the payer is also included in this bill. A number of GST related changes are also proposed, and it is proposed that certain non-resident businesses may register for GST and claim input tax deductions for GST incurred, with some restrictions to protect the tax base. It is also proposed, Mr Speaker, that all local authorities move to an invoice accounting base for GST. Other substantive measures include changes to the time periods for claiming refunds under the Income Tax Act 2007, ensuring that expenditure on trees and plantings for erosion, shelter and water protection purposes is tax deductible, and clarification of the definition of dividend in relation to certain rights issues, premiums paid under book building arrangements and share splits by companies. Mr Speaker, also included in this bill are two additions to the bill made by supplementary order paper. These made remedial changes which respectively align the Tax Administration Act 1994 with the Search and Surveillance Act 2012 and make minor technical adjustments to the Child Support Amendment Act 2013. These are the main features of this bill. Together, these measures will help strengthen our tax system and support our economy by ensuring that people more fairly pay tax that's due. Mr Speaker, it is a good bill, and I would like to thank and acknowledge officials for their contribution in developing the policy and the drafters who worked on the detail of the legislation. I'd like to also thank the hard-working Select Committee of Finance and Expenditure for its close consideration of the proposed reforms. Great consideration was given, and I do know members on both sides of the House spent extra time delightfully reading this important legislation in draft form at home in their weekends. Mr Speaker, I'm pleased to commend this bill to the House.
The question is that the motion be agreed to.
Mr Speaker.
Honourable David Cunliffe.
Mr Speaker.